sisters and brothers, let us continue our celebration in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you always. As we gather here today to do so, to celebrate this vigil, Mass of the Feast of Pentecost, when the Church was given the gift of the Holy Spirit. As we celebrate these sacred mysteries, I invite us to first call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us from the last thing of life.
That is why it was called Babel, because there the Lord confused the speech of all the world. It was from that place that he scattered them all over the earth. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
stood up and exclaimed, "Let anyone who thirsts come to me and drink. As scriptures say, rivers of the living water will flow from within who believes in me." He said this in reference to the Spirit, that those who came to believe in him were to receive. There was, of course, no Spirit yet, because Jesus had not yet been glorified. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. You don't have to know me very long at all before you realize I make a really big deal out of my birthday. I always figure I like to give people as much advance warning as possible, so everybody write this down, January 22nd. My birthday, we don't want anybody to miss it. Now, the question is, why are birthdays important? I always think, well, it can't be special one month. I mean, one day a year. What's the point? Can't be special one day a year. But really, I use birthdays as an opportunity to really take stock of my life, to really ask myself, you know, what have I been able to accomplish in the past year? And more importantly, what do I hope to accomplish in an upcoming year? Birthdays as milestones are an opportunity for us to really examine what's going well in our lives, what are the things that we want to work on, and what's the directions we want to go moving into the future. Oftentimes, we try to do that, of course, on January 1st for the new year, but then everything is so hectic. It's a hectic time of the year. We find that birthdays are a time to take stock, to look past, back on the past year of my life, to look forward into the future. And that's really, it's a good exercise. It's a good practice to get into. We don't want life just to carry us away. We really focus on the things that really do matter. As we celebrate the Feast of Pentecost, we're celebrating the feast of the birthday of the church. That those disciples were hiding out in the upper room. Jesus had already been suffered and died on the cross, and rose from the dead, ascended up into heaven. The gift of the Holy Spirit was given to those disciples, and they went from being in hiding to very boldly proclaiming the good news of the gospel. And one of the reasons that we wear red at the Feast of Pentecost, which is a symbol of the Holy Spirit, is also a reminder that those apostles all went on to martyrdom. The apostles, when we celebrate the feast of the apostles, we wear red because we know that they were martyred. So they had good reason to be afraid in that upper room. They had reason to know that they were living in fear, and yet they chose that it was more important for them to live as people who were truly spreading the good news that Jesus came into the world to provide than even to protect their own lives. And so as we celebrate this birthday of the church, I think it's an opportunity for us to also take stock and ask, where have we been in the last year as a church, as a people of God, both collectively and individually? And then to ask ourselves, where exactly do we want to see ourselves a year from now? The Feast of Pentecost is an opportunity for us to really take stock of those things that are most important to us. And we see that now with all the rules and regulations is starting to change with hopefully the end of the pandemic is in sight. The CDC is constantly coming up with new guidelines. People are asking themselves, what's going to be different? What changes are they going to make? And some of the news articles today are saying that some people aren't quite ready yet to go out into that world. There's some things that they don't want to give up. They don't want to give up the time they were spending with the family. They didn't want to give up those lessons that have been learned during this very difficult past year and a half. And I know that in my own life, as we all know, I went through a very difficult time this past month. It would be impossible for me just personally not to take stock and see where do I want to put my energy, my time, and my effort now re-engaging back into the life of the parish. And so I think this is an opportunity for all of us to really examine our lives and to seek the guidance of the Holy Spirit.
not just to make the decisions that we want to make, but rather to ask ourselves, where is God directing me? Where is God guiding me? Where is God calling me to be? And so as we celebrate this feast of the Pentecost, I encourage each and every one of us to take personal stock of our own faith lives and to really ask God, where are we being directed? And then as a parish community, I think it's also important for us to see where is the Holy Spirit calling us as a community of faith. And I myself am extremely committed not only to listening to the voice of God in prayer, but also to the leadership that has just done such a phenomenal job during these difficult days. On this feast of Pentecost, let us ask God to fill us with the Spirit, personally and collectively. Let us ask God to continue to guide us in all that we do.
Let's also pray for a true and just and lasting peace in the Middle East, as
especially for those living in Palestine and in Israel, we pray to the Lord. And let us also remember Kevin Barron, who returned to the Lord. We pray to the Lord. Loving God, we ask you to do the prayers of your faithful gathered here today, the prayers spoken aloud, and those lighting within our hearts. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Spirit.
light to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather people to yourself, so that the rising of the sun would set, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving me thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
by the help of your mercy, may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant you peace and unity, in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever." The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us extend to each other the sign of Christ's peace.
Blessed go forth in peace, and as is ended, alleluia, alleluia.